dream. Am I in a dream? I don't know where I am, really. I was at the movies. Dreams, dreams, dreams. Is this a dream? Am I dreaming? I'm Peter Travers. I'm the movie critic for Rolling Stone, and I'm supposed to be here and tell you about Inception, which is a dream movie, but watching it is like being lost in a dream. I keep wanting to claw myself out of it. There's not only a dream world in this movie, it's like three layers of dreams in it. And you know what? This is a movie directed and written by Christopher Nolan, who gave us The Dark Knight. It stars Leonardo DiCaprio, who runs this dream team. He's got people that help him invade your dreams. Why do they do that for? Well, they're hired by corporations to go in and find out what people are thinking in their dreams so they could exploit it for fun and profit. But because it's called Inception, that means that Leonardo DiCaprio's character is doing something really weird this time. He, instead of extracting information from a dream, is being told to put information in that dream. Are you confused yet? You know what I'm saying to you people? You need to man up about this movie. I've already heard people say, it's too complicated for me. Oh, I can't understand it. It's too tough. I don't. You know, they said that about The Matrix too. I can't get it. I can't. Come on, don't we see enough crap? Don't we see enough like jerk-off easy comedies that are out there where we sit there and it just goes in like in waves over us and we're not even provoked to think. In this movie, you are provoked to think. What do I need to tell you about it? That Christopher Nolan is a visionary? He is, you know? Is he sometimes complicated? Yes, he is. But just knowing this, that you have Leonardo DiCaprio starring in a movie, again, where he's pushing the envelope. And the members of his team here are great. You got Joseph Gordon-Levitt, who has a zero gravity scene you just won't believe. It's so interesting and complicated. You got a guy named Tom Hardy who was in Bronson, this indie movie that I kept telling you should see, who is terrific in this movie. Even Ellen Page, Juno herself, is in it, playing a member of the team who really is us in the audience. She'll always say to DiCaprio, whose dream are we in anyway? I'm just a little confused. She's gonna help straighten this out for you. Marion Cotillard, Academy Award winner for Love Beyond Roses, is also in it. She is the wife of Leonardo DiCaprio, who is lost to him and deep in dreams. Does Leo want to go so deep into that third level of dreams that he never comes up and he lives with this wife who is completely turned on existence? Or does he want reality and the two children that he has somewhere in this world? I'm saying no more. This is a smart movie in the dumbest summer ever. It's worth dreaming with it because you'll see it and don't let anybody ask you after you see it, did you like it or not? Because you won't know. It's gonna take you a couple of days. You're gonna have to live with it. In fact, you should come back. I should be having a whole special show where we just talk about your theories about what this movie really means. You know, Inception is a definite dream of a movie. If you want a nightmare of a movie, go see The Sorcerer's Apprentice. This is the worst that Hollywood could do. This is Jerry Bruckheimer remaking the Disney animated classic Fantasia, or at least the Sorcerer's Apprentice section of it. So you have Nicolas Cage at his most adenoidal and annoying, playing the sorcerer. You have Jay Baruchel playing his apprentice so that Jay gets to teach the little broomsticks and everything like Mickey Mouse did in Fantasia to dance. So many special effects, so much stupidity, so much boom, boom, boom that doesn't mean anything. Yes, Sorcerer's Apprentice for nightmares, but let me and you and all of us that love movies dream with Inception. I'm Peter Travers.